We have to do it is like this.
Have I returned? Can you hear me?
Yes.
I can hear you, yeah.
Okay. So now what do I do? Because the game is on your screen or
yeah,
something.
I'm
gonna,
I'm gonna stream it to you on Discord.
Okay.
On Discord. Can you see? Where's Katie?
How do I? Yeah. Okay. There we go. I full screened it.
Katie, can you hear me?
Yeah. Hi.
Is this made by that guy who you showed me the Twitter where it was like really abstract?
No.
Or is that something else? I haven't played any of those yet.
Oh, did you download those?
No, I haven't played any of them yet. I haven't.
I see. I see what you're saying. Okay, so if I do that, and then I have game capture this. Hang on, you shouldn't be able to hear anything right now. Okay, this is Matt's first time playing this. There we go. All right.
I can't wait.
Yeah.
I'm so excited.
Sonoshi. Sonoshi. You can now wishlist this game on Steam. Ooh. Okay. I'll do that.
Can you hear this, Matt?
Yes.
Okay.
Is this made by the people who made Obra Dinn?
This guy doesn't have any other games up on his thing. I think he's just solely working on this.
I like how there's Arabic underneath the word sale.
Yeah.
Okay. The frame rate looks a bit weird, but I don't know if that's because of the game or you.
It might just be the streaming, because I'm streaming to you and streaming to Twitch at the same time. So
okay.
And streaming
so
to Katie
Snake
also.
And goats are white. Does that mean that those are the only two we can do?
Yeah, these are the only two we can do right now. But Snake was the first one to come out, so let's pop
okay.
There. Okay, so you make
can't
all the
wait.
Choices.
I love
I'm just gonna click on whatever you tell me.
Okay.
Okay, so you are Sergey. You're 27, November 2033, the Limelight Club in New York.
Okay.
You want to read it out? Can you read that?
Your phone's ringtone disrupts a good night's. You take your phone to check the message you just received.
That's your ringtone.
Meet me at 4 a.m. in the limelight. A text message from Michael Jackson, huh? Okay. You must be Chris and his lame attempts at humor.
Can I just say something? Can you touch the phone at all?
No.
Okay.
It looks like you can because that's blinking. All right, so satisfied.
So
Michael
did
Jackson's
you put
request?
Your name in as Chris, or is
no.
It just a co- because it says Sergey.
Yeah.
It's what?
Yeah. That was Sergey's inner monologue. I guess he has a friend named Chris. Katie thought Katie was convinced I was fucking with her.
Yeah, I really did. I was like, he's fucking with me. I was like, what are you going to do?
All right, satisfy Michael's request.
So I would like to go back to sleep.
Okay. I'm not falling for this, not at 3 in the morning.
Yeah.
I've never done this
either.
Later that night, the discomforting cold air in the room interrupts your sleep, and soon you wake up again.
Oh my god. Yeah, I haven't seen this one either. What the?
Ooh.
Oh!
What is this?
Sexy!
I can't move. What is happening? You start thinking about how being paralyzed with a terrorizing figure next to you is an indicator of sleep paralysis.
Oh god.
Oh, okay. And then if you could close your eyes... This... would...
all go away.
Go away. Oh, I can't tell if my stream lagged or the game lagged. Okay.
Oh, God.
However, this doesn't seem to be another episode of Sleep Paralysis. You have to at least grip on who is something. The perpetrator watching you die with a cold gaze utters a few words that you know will be your last.
I've never seen this. Third Noid Man.
Man. You can't escape us, little one. The Third Noid Man?
That's amazing. Oh my god.
Meet Michael Jackson at 4 a.m. in the limelight.
Amazing.
Okay.
I love this. I think this needs to be like an initiation video. Game for
you
people to
play.
Everyone
up here on my stream, you have to buy critters for sale with me.
That, yes, I'm not kidding.
Okay. Maxwell's message from Michael Jackson. Leave the comfort. All right, let's go to the club. Now, I've never been to the limelight, but it's just around the corner. I should check out what this is about. Okay, so first off, it says the location is the Limelight Club, which is clearly wrong. I was in my bed till now, so.
You'll see. All right, Limelight. I think the only thing to do is click the door, so I'll do that.
Enter the club, yes. Oh, so you can click pick things in the picture.
Yeah, sometimes. This is so Twin Peaksy.
Yeah.
Also, this is how you go back. I love this. It looks so
cool. What do you mean, how you go back?
Like when you want to go back, like exit the club, these arrows come up, and I don't know. There's something about them.
I see. They mean like move backwards.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Okay, so anything.
They cut the cat. Cat's at you. An innate inclination to break this intricate piece of art is still
settling in you.
Settling in you?
Settling
in you?
Yeah, the words are really, they can be really hard to read.
The font is
Can I break it? Touch it. Break it. Shake it. Shake it. Shake it with the mouse. Ooh. Okay, that's mine now. Take it.
That's mine now.
He seems to be embedded in the sculpture. You decide not to take it.
No, I'm taking it. It's mine.
Alright, let's head back.
I'm gonna go. I don't want to talk to that man. I'm just gonna go straight in. Maybe I should talk to the receptionist first before going any further. Can I use the key?
Mm-mm.
No. Okay, I'll talk to him.
Good evening. Welcome to the limelight.
Ooh, the jazz, the saxophone came in right this touch.
How may I be of help?
Okay. I was invited to the nightclub by someone calling themselves Michael Jackson.
May I have your name?
Sergey. Sergey Volkov. I like the music.
I love the jazz. Music, yeah. Oh, yes, yeah. Of course. You're listed as a VIP guest.
Sounds like Bowerden's or Club of Gore. VIP?
I think it is Club of Gore.
Is that the actual, like...
I looked up a bunch of... Because in the credits it tells you all the music. It is Club of Gore. Oh.
It is?
Yeah, I know for a fact it is.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah, because I was going to say, it sounds exactly like them.
Well, I know they're in this game, and this is probably them if you recognize them. Okay, so you said VIP?
Yep.
1 minute, Mr. Sergey. We will escort you to the entrance of the club.
Actually, I'd like to discover the place myself. Where will I find the entrance?
It's through that door, see you. Traverse the corridor, and you'll find the door leading to the lobby. Okay, so... advance?
Yes.
Okay.
Straight ahead. I don't like either of those doors. Yes. Straight ahead. I don't like either of those doors. Can I look at the painting? Painting the Giza pyramids. Let's lose myself in its beauty.
All right, Eminem.
Okay. I'm satisfied.
Can't click on anything else. All right.
Yeah, go back. Okay, so where would Michael Jackson be? Well, let's ask the cat.
That's the cat. Aww.
Her name is Mia. You don't know how you know, but you do. Little one, spare this timeline. Spare this timeline's doom and enter the door in front of me. I don't know. I trust it. I'm gonna trust the cat. Let's go inside. Let's go in the door.
This door?
Because the other one's all glitching out anyway. No, it said the one in front.
This is locked. I just know that. So this is the door she was talking about.
Oh, okay.
This
I guess that makes sense.
However, in front of her, as opposed the key to... withdrew from the sculpture at the reception desk seems to be compatible.
Okay.
Attempt Let's unlocking?
Yes. I knew it was my key. Like, see? Told you.
The door has been unlocked.
Okay.
Enter the room?
Yeah.
Good evening, Sergei. Glad to see you in good shape. Which will it be this time?
Well, the Noidmen killed me, so fuck it. I'm gonna go to the highest council.
You shall be commemorated at the highest of skies, undaunted human. Take this. Push the trigger
when you're ready.
Your legacy will be celebrated for as long as the highest council exists.
Okay, cool.
It's time for me to go. I'm counting on you. So long, Sergei.
Okay.
Do I have to press the button? Is there anything else I can do? Can I walk away?
No.
All right. Press it. Yes.
You suicide bombed.
Oh, okay. Okay. Is that game over?
It says 2033 marked the long-awaited demise of an interdimensional travel landmark, the Limelight Club.
Shit.
You died.
Huh. Okay. But the Noidmen killed me, so I didn't want to serve them.
Yeah.
So maybe I just shouldn't go in there. I'm not gonna trust the cat. I should never have trusted the cat. Alright, let's go to the limelight.
I should never have trusted the cat.
Yeah.
Matt, 2020.
Yeah, let's go inside.
Alright, are we doing anything in here?
I'm just gonna go straight through and talk to the guy so he can go in.
Oh, excuse me.
Okay. All right.
Let's do the door on the right.
Locked.
Okay. Door on the left.
Locked.
Ceiling. Leave. Let's leave the club. Let's go back home.
Let's leave the club. Go back home.
Let's go back home. Let's go back home.
Oh, this is as far back as we can go.
Okay.
That sucks.
Ceiling. Leave.
Wait, I think you could say no, but...
I think you just stay there, probably.
Yeah.
Alright, go forward. Go forward. Go forward again. Go forward again.
Oh my god.
Stop.
Okay.
So the music stopped. So use the door on the right.
Lock.
Door on the left. All right, keep going forward. Ooh. Okay.
Ooh.
Let's go forward. The lobby, yes. Oh, proceed.
I don't know why it was down instead of up.
Yeah, that was weird.
To trick you.
This is probably my favorite music.
Yeah, me too.
Ooh, I like that guy's leg.
Who do you want to talk to first?
Okay. Can I... The guy with the leg, obviously.
Hey, do you want to be long-nosed man? And I'll be long-nosed man too.
Yeah. What do you... Okay, but can we do this in, like, Italian, like, New York accents?
Yeah, you first.
What do you think he has in the suitcase?
Shut the fuck up, man. Shut the fuck up. I told you to just keep on dancing.
But I'm telling you, he never brings the suitcase.
So what? Could be his late night snack in there for all we know.
Or it could be tonight is the night, you know?
Shut the fuck up. That's what you. That's just what you want to hear. I'm watching him. Just blend in. Keep dancing. Look, those are their noses, man. Alright, who now?
Well, so I can either talk to the suitcase man, or I could try and go to the back of the room. Let's go to the back of the room. I want to find Michael Jackson.
Oh, what?
Oh!
I've never clicked on this.
What the fuck?
Can you click his teeth?
Ew, I hate him.
Wait, I've never seen this!
What?
No, you just go back.
Yeah, I don't remember that at all.
Okay.
Was he in the back?
I clicked on the little window in the back.
Okay, can you click the shelf next to Briefcase Man? The bar or something? No? Yeah. Alright, then let's talk to Briefcase Man.
You want to talk to Briefcase Man last.
What did you say?
You want to talk to Briefcase Man last.
Oh, okay. Alright, I'll talk to Dress Girl.
Katie.
A beautiful night. But at what cost?
I want to talk to her again.
A beautiful night. But at what cost?
Alright, I want to talk to Dancing Girl.
Okay.
Ooh, can I be Dancing Girl?
No. Matt, read it out.
Oh, okay.
Their legs were slender and their abdomens yellow, making me believe that they were exotic bugs from somewhere exotic, you know?
She's British.
So, me being who I am, I decided to let them bite for science. Trust me. Those little fuckers had the worst of all the bites. The worst!
No swearing!
And so, me being who I am, the thought, the tough yet pain-prone individual who can't make no shit from a mosquito. Oh!
Oh, hang on.
Oh. That was weird.
I was gonna lower the volume.
Oh no, everything disappeared. There's no name, no age, no date, no location.
Yeah, and the words went away, and so did the music.
They'll come back. Hang on, I'm just gonna lower the volume.
You don't know that.
You don't know.
You don't know that. I slap the motherfucker, and again, maybe me, I pick the mosquito pulp and savor it. It actually tasted good. I shit you not. The best I've tasted as far as mosquitoes go. Well, it doesn't compare to the taste of a snake. But the tang sure had those exotic undertones in it. Can we talk to the girl in the dress again?
But at what cost?
Alright, the one in the far back.
You know what I'm thinking? It's amazing how sound can transcend its physical manifestation to infuse us with all sorts of emotions. I wonder if scientists ever looked into that. Like, how? I don't get it.
Can you touch the ceiling lights in the corners? Like those big ones? No? Alright, then the bowler hat and umbrella. Guy looks like
I want to be him. To be honest, this is the type of music I'm used to. And it's not what teens these days are listening to either. It's halfway between the taste and mine, if that makes sense.
Alright, briefcase guy.
Can you touch the poles?
Nah.
Yeah, can I touch the poles? Can we look at the DJ again?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I wanted to.
I hate him.
Alright, let's touch the briefcase. Oh, Michael! Michael Jackson! Ooh!
Oh, no. Sergey, you found your way here.
No.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing great. Such a beautiful night in this club with beautiful people in it too. How do you like the limelight?
It's mesmerizing. Clubs in general invoke the claustrophobia in me, and yet I feel absolute ease in here. You know, from the outside, it looks damn near impossible for it to accommodate that long corridor. I must have walked miles before getting here.
Indeed, it's a long way before you reach the inside. But it's worth it. The music that plays here is timeless.
Excuse me for asking, but how do you know me? I don't think we've met before.
You will remember soon enough.
I like your Michael Jackson.
You and I share an intimate friendship in a future you haven't lived yet.
I don't understand. You and I will become friends in the future, and you somehow know that?
I don't just know it. I've seen it. You have no idea what you and I will go through. Even if I told you, you wouldn't believe me. Most fascinating trips through space and time. The civilizations will meet and the lives will change. We're time travelers, Sergey.
I really don't think I'm the person you believe I am. Are you sure you're not somehow mistaken?
Sergey Volkov, a 27-year-old taxi driver who lives right around the corner? Are you Sergey?
No. I'm Chris. I apologize, but that's not me.
Then vanish, rancid soul.
I keep getting banned.
Wait, what? What? I don't. Oh my god!
You think I can't see right through your shit, Sergey? If you don't want to take part of this again, then you can fuck off back to the grave.
Why? Wait, I'm so... What?
So, like, oh. They really don't. They don't let you get away with being wrong.
Yeah. I never did that before. I never saw that, so I was curious what that one was.
All right. I might go lay down.
Katie, you're gonna miss a goat. Oh,
already? I'm already laying down. I don't. Wow. I'm just. It's just like I've been doing that for at least an hour. All right. Let's go straight back to Michael Jackson.
Okay.
I'll tell him who I am.
Sounds disappointed.
Fine. I am disappointed. I thought I'd probably be like, I'm Chris, because someone said, mentions Chris earlier on.
I guess he has a friend named Chris. He goes, this is probably one of Chris's lame jokes.
You paid to have, because like I've always wondered that if you have like an obscure band you find and you want their music in your game, like how much do they charge you? Because they're just like some German bands that no one's heard of except for like me and other Germans probably. I'll ask. I know a couple of Germans. I'm gonna ask them if they know of Corbin and their Club of Gore. Maybe they're like, oh yes,
oh yes,
like, they played that one time.
Oh yes,
I can't do a German. I can't do it at all.
I love the transition. Michael changes his face. Katie, if you're tired, you can go to sleep.
She said she wants to lay down, not go to sleep. You didn't listen to her.
Yeah, Chris.
Are you Sergey?
Yes.
No, I mean, you're already at Michael Jackson, so... I'll wait until you're done with Snake, and then...
Okay.
Yep, that's
but goat is so good.
So what you're saying is true, then you're the same Michael Jackson from the past?
You don't believe me? Did you really think I was an imposter?
Uh-huh. No, not at all. I believe you. It's just hard to fathom all at once, I guess.
Be patient. You will soon find the answers when you meet the Noidmen. They should be here shortly. Now, I have to get going. I'm performing a dance tonight.
They're on stage?
Yes. The Noidmen will show up after I'm done. I hope to see you in good shape when we meet again. Hey, Katie, you're gonna miss this.
I know, as I'm trying almost, to say. Like, stay awake for it.
You almost missed his dance.
Ooh.
Oh my god.
Is that a real Michael Jackson clip? Or like, what am I talking
about? Yeah, I think so.
It's just all the weird
things. This is so funny.
He's fading in and out.
Yeah, he's vibing.
He's straight up not having a good time, yo.
Oh no. The second Noidman.
Can you read it in like a Noidman voice, Matt?
Your time is up, Michael. What is going on? I must be dreaming.
Sergey, you're not dreaming. I will be seeing you soon. 12 years from now, your second daughter's birthday.
What does that say? Toodle pip?
Toodle pip.
Come back to the club, old friend. Who are you? I'm a familiar face. You know you've seen me before.
Is that Mads Mikkelsen?
Lose yourself in his familiarity? No. Oh, I have no choice. Yes.
Sudden burst of flashbacks.
Caesar restored your memory. Remember me now? Of course I do. Let's not waste any more time. We've got places to be. So that's the spirit. Let's get going. He's waving around. He's so strict.
You lived! Yay!
You did it, Matt.
I never saw the critter.
I never saw a critter.
I never sold a critter. All right, Katie.
Didn't something mention a snake at some point?
Yeah.
What was it? I can't remember.
She said the mosquito doesn't taste as good as snake, but it's still good.
Yeah. Okay. So, Katie, did you ever, what happens if you devote yourself to the Noid Man when you go through that door?
Oh,
did you do that?
Yeah, it just it kills you instantly.
Okay.
Oh, fair. No. You devote yourself to the Noid Men, the face disappears, and you can't leave the room. It's just a big, black, empty space, and then you starve to death.
Oh, yeah? Mm-hmm.
Katie, will you at least watch Goat and hang out in the chat?
Oh yeah, that was my plan, but you can do Goat. I'll stay for Goat. I'll stay as long as I can.
Okay. You need to lay down. Look at me. You can see I'm laying down. No problems for me. I've got a tiger bomb. I'm gonna put some tiger bomb on, and I'm gonna be
Matt
laying
put
down.
Tiger bomb on.
Oh my god, what is that?
You don't know what tiger bomb is?
Ooh. You're gonna make Matt put tiger bomb on.
Chris. She doesn't know what Tiger Mom is. Do you know what Tiger Mom is?
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, of course you do. Better know.
It's better not to know.
I like to put it on right before I go out in public because then people are like, what's that smell?
Tiger Mom.
Did you know in Indonesia, they think that if you put Tiger Mom on your back and then you take the this one's not as sharp, but I guess the ones in Indonesia are sharp. And they scrape the person's back after they put the tiger bomb on it, so it makes these stripes. And I was talking to someone who said that I can't remember what country they were in. I think it was somewhere in Europe. And an Indonesian man was in Europe, and someone was doing that to their back, and the police came, and they didn't know what was going on, so they started yelling, and the guy ran away. And then the person who's got the tiger bomb on his back started crying because he was scared. And they thought that he was being attacked. And then an Indonesian person came in and was just like, oh no, that guy was just getting a tiger bomb on his back and you scared him and that's why he's crying. they thought the scratches on his back were he was being tortured or something.
They're like, oh, poor thing.
No, it's just tiger bomb and they just scraped his back because they think that if you do that, They think you can get sick from wind or something like that. It's like a superstition. And so if you do this, it gives you like a shield against the wind.
Oh.
So he was trying to get his windshield, and then the cops scared his friend away, and he started crying.
It's amazing.
Aw.
Let's do the goat.
Gator, are you in or out?
Wait, what happened if you do the credits? Did the credits?
Oh, what are the credits? Oh.
Music.
Club of Gore.
Oh, yeah. Street Tattoo. Yeah, okay. I know that song. I knew it sounded super cool. Or actually, wait, no. I don't. Street Tattoo wasn't the one we were listening to, though. So that's for Goat. Oh, no, it is.
No, this is for Snake.
Theo Parrish. Theo Parrish, What You Cry For.
And well, yeah, I wonder how much money he had to like pay to get them to license it for the game.
I don't know.
Like,
I mean,
I was making a game, and I was just like, hey, I know this obscure person no one else has any views for. Well, how much would I pay them?
He just used Michael Jackson's likeness.
Oh, that's
true. After he died.
Yeah, maybe he's just not. Because this is free, I'm guessing?
Yeah.
Or something? Mm. Yeah, okay, so it just doesn't
matter. It's an itch.io game.
What's that mean?
It's just a website called itch.io, and you can buy a bunch
so
of
it, games. So it's not, yeah, it's not retail, so that's why
gotcha.
He doesn't need to worry. Mm. All right, Jafar, age 42. July 1925.
No, 923.
Oh, 925.
Oh, that's a 30.
The Arabian Desert, Jordan, temperature 38 degrees Celsius. That's hot. That hot. It's pretty hot. That's like a hot Australian day. Middle of Jordan Desert. George. Ooh, sexy. And you're resting on sand, keeping a lookout for Stefan's silhouette on the horizon.
Stefan's silhouette. Is the stream coming through okay?
Yep. Well, okay.
Yeah.
That's what it is. In front of you is the tent in which you and Stefan stayed for most of the past week.
I have it on my phone. It's running good.
Oh, okay.
This reminds me of Begotten.
Of what? Begotten?
Begotten.
Oh,
it's
my God.
Yeah,
I've seen Begotten. It's so scary. I should make that in my Be Right Back video. Begotten.
That's a movie. Like, I've never watched the full movie. I remember I saw someone's review of it was just like, this movie is simultaneously horrifying and boring. And it's true. Like,
yeah, it is.
I can only watch, like, I can watch it for, like, 2 or 3 minutes at a time and be really uncomfortable. And then I'm like, I'm bored.
How long is it?
So I've never actually seen the whole, it's like a full length movie, but I just like jump around in it whenever I have tried to watch it because I can't actually just watch it.
It's really boring.
It's really more of a thing that's it's like the kind of thing that just really should be kind of just playing on a screen and then you're doing other things in like a museum or something. No?
Yeah, but you can't do laundry with Begotten playing in the background.
No, I don't know, but it's like you also can't really sit down and watch it too. Like, I don't know what I'm glad it exists because it's like so horrifying. But at the same time, I don't know what to do with it because I don't really want to watch it.
Exactly. Isn't it about Jesus?
It's about like the
killing Jesus.
It's like God. The beginning of the movie is God kills himself and then he poops and then Mother Nature comes out from like his corpse or something, and then I think she has a son, and I think I don't remember what the son is meant to be, but I know God is the guy who kills himself at the beginning of the movie, and Mother Nature is who comes out of it. She has a son. I don't remember who the son is, and then there's like the humans who are cannibals or whatever, and they eat her. I don't remember.
Katie.
Anyway,
What, Katie, go lay down, Katie.
Katie loves Begotten. That's like she on Tinder. Your Tinder profile says, "I love Begotten."
I literally don't have Tinder.
Well, you don't need to have Tinder right now. Like, that doesn't mean your profile is Tinder. Saved just on, like, says,
"I love
somewhere.
Begotten." A movie about God killing himself and pooping out.
You know, and the way he kills himself too, he's like with spastic movements. Like, it looks like he's in like so much pain that he can't chop his own guts properly. It's just so awful. It's Katie's favorite film, and she has her one of the, when you swipe, like, you know, you see all the different pictures on Tinder, and then one of them's like an animated gif of just like God vomiting blood.
My favorite movie. I quote it all the time.
What if there was an anime remake of Begotten? And it was really cute, and like whenever he's in pain, he goes, "Yeah."
Oh my god.
He just has the little cross on his forehead because he's upset. the sweat drop appears because it's taking him so long to die. All right. Let's go inside the tent. Click that. All right, I want to go on the right bed. On the right. Yeah. Oh, I was right. See, I knew it.
You were drawn to it.
Is that Stefan's? Yeah. Bed. Okay, go to the thing in the middle. And while I look at, no, I want to go to the bedside table. Really? It's a nice tent, though.
Yeah.
It's so nice, right?
Yeah. Like, they carried those beds out there. A goat, finally. What's the goat looking at? Can you touch the dead bodies, please?
The dead bodies. Alright, what are we doing?
Stefan. Actually, no, touch the goat. I want to touch that goat. There's a goat outside. I could technically go touch a real goat right now.
Oh my god.
Darkness. But I have to wander through the darkness to get to it. A goat that belongs to you. Cool. Can you touch its eye? You thought she would make good company during the trip and a better slaughter if you ran out of food. Okay, can't touch its eye.
Can you touch its eye?
Love it.
Matt sees a goat and he has to poke it in the eye immediately.
This is what I do in real life.
I check if it's my goat and then I poke it in the eye.
Can you touch? Oh, did I?
Can you do Stefan Burton Burnett impression?
I don't know who that is. It also reminded me that when I went because of touching the goat's eye, there's also a chicken coop, and I walked up over to the chicken coop, and all the chickens were inside. It's like a little building, like you can't see inside, but then there's these flaps that you can open up so that you can get the eggs out.
Yeah,
and so. They were all in there, and I was just like, I'm going to go up to them and open the flap and just kind of see if I can look inside. And I couldn't see the chickens, but you can hear them all kind of like getting annoyed because they know someone's nearby. So they're going, bark, 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 bark. And then when I opened up the thing, the flap to look inside, one of them literally just went, bark, bark, bark. It's just really funny.
I love that, making like chicken noises.
It literally, like, it sounds like I could imagine that same tone of voice in the woman being like, "What's that? What's that?" Like, that's what it sounded like. Chicken. It was really funny.
What's that?
Bukar! Bukar! All right. Anyway, that was my country goat pie story.
My touching goat's eye story. Oh no, hang on. I messed up my monitor.
Alright. All right, touch Jafar. I don't know who Stephon Burnett is. Is he a basketball player?
he's the singer of the band The Death Grips.
I don't know that band.
What would he sound like?
I don't know. I was just kind of, I don't know, something about, like, his face that looks like a basketball player's, like, profile pic, you know?
Oh, like...
Like, whenever you see, like... I don't know what
it is. Just their shoulders.
No, because, like, this exact profile thing is what they use for, like, sports.
Yeah, and they always have the same kind of grin, because it's, like, an awkward, like, smile that while they're waiting, you know, when you're, like, taking, like, a camera photo. And you have to wait for it. Like, that's what that looks like. And that's what I was like. It's
awful. Did you see his smile grow?
But he's not wearing a jersey. That's the only thing. And also his beard, I guess. I don't know. Would they let you play basketball with a beard that's uneven?
Yeah, but he doesn't play that. He sings. He's a singer.
I know, but what I'm saying is, like, that's why I thought that. But now I'm looking at his beard. It's like, oh, they probably would have yelled at him.
Basketball.
You're making up this whole fictional basketball career for this
man. I don't know why. It's just like that. I don't know. There's something about the exact like height of the profile that just feels like a basketball. Anyway, move on. Okay, click.
I did.
What did you find there? What did you find? What did you find?
We stopped smiling.
Oh.
Oh, do you want me to be Stefan?
I thought it was Katie who was going to be Stefan.
Oh, I want to be Stefan?
Yeah.
I thought you were Stefan.
Oh. It's hard to explain, but the voice I hear tells me to follow the path along which I feel most composed. And composure, I felt as if the fatigue from this weeks-long pilgrimage was racing off of each step. Off by each step.
Aren't those good news? Let's march forth, then.
But I suggest we
leave by the tent. Hmm?
Aww. Why is that? I don't want to leave my goat alone.
Do you want to be Stefan or do you want to be another character? Do you want to be the character?
You could be Stefan.
Do you want to be the character I'm thinking of?
Yeah, I do.
Rumor has it, critters approaching the cave seethe and rampage against their owners.
Oh. No, my goat is too important to me.
Okay.
I'm not gonna leave the goat behind.
This is you.
I can't leave it behind by myself. I need the goat. There's no way I can leave the goat behind. Surely this is not going to result in me dying. No way.
You brought it in case you got hungry.
Yeah, like... No. Clearly I'm... Okay. Alright, I can't leave her by herself. I can't.
And this is you.
Yeah, trust me, the goat wouldn't hurt a fly. I can't leave her here by herself. Trust me. She needs company, so I say we bring her along.
And then march forth.
Alright, touch the dead bodies.
It does look like dead bodies.
It does. Now that you point that out.
Are we clicking on anybody or just going forth?
Click the goat. I want to see how the goat's doing. Touch its eye. Okay.
Alright.
Keep going. Go down the pass. Yes.
Path?
Ooh. No, I want to talk to my friends.
We should
I want to see what
consider
he's doing.
ourselves lucky to have the cave so easily accessible to anyone looking for it.
All right, I checked the goat.
Oh.
Oh, how is spending weeks slumped in the open desert considered accessible?
You'd be relieved to learn that in its first reports, some two thieves were seen wandering around the cave's whereabouts. Aggressive, hostile, otherworldly figures.
Otherworldly, you say? And you believe that?
The voice I hear inside me is tangible as yours, then I would believe anything associated with this cave.
Okay.
Goat?
Yeah, click that goat. Touch his
Goodbye.
eye. Yeah, touch his eye. Touch his teeth. He's smiling.
Yeah. Nothing.
Yes, go back, go back. Yes. Touch the sun.
I know, I always want to.
Me too.
Touch the goat. We gotta check up on that goat.
He's smiling again.
Make sure it's okay. Okay. Goats.
What?
Oh, what's up?
What's up?
What's up? Wait, Stefan, did you hear that?
Hear what?
The goat said something. I must be hallucinating.
Want to talk to Stefan?
All right, let's go. No.
No.
Yes.
Goat?
Touch the goat. Touch that goat.
Stop staring at me. I would appreciate it if you could just let me be.
Good goodness,
Oh.
tell me you heard that, Stefan.
It's definitely possessed.
Possess my ass. You lot amaze me, acting as if you've never seen a goat talk before.
I told you we should have left it behind.
Stop eyeballing me, both of you.
So the rumors were true?
Stop fucking staring
Click its eye
at
quick.
me.
Stop staring at you.
Hi.
Did I stutter?
Yes.
My
Yes,
God.
Stefan. Oh my
Stefan.
God, Stefan.
Your goat penetrates Stefan's chest and gapes it open, rendering him dead on the floor.
You're next, Jafar.
Click on its eye.
No, no.
You
No. My
died.
goat killed me.
All right, I'll stick around and chat, but I'm gonna go lay down.
Okay.
You're not already laying down?
No, I'm in my computer chair.
Wow.
The worst.
Wow.
Sorry.
Wow.
Good night, Katie.
Good night. I'll be in chat.
Okey-dokey.
Yeah. I believe you.
Bye.
I believe you. Good night, dude. Love you,
All right.
Katie.
Good night.
Should we try goat one more time?
Oh yeah. They're not very long. That. Ooh. The garbage men have come. It is time for the garbage men. Oh fuck, where is that thing? It's not display, it's window capture. There we go. And then chat goat. Oh, and then we gotta fix. Window capture. Stop. Okay, there we go. All right, go. Go. Goat was Katie's favorite, and she passed out. I'll get us up to picking the goat or not.
What was that?
I'll get us up to picking the goat or not.
Yeah, I'll leave it behind this time. I really am upset, though. I love my goat.
Look at him smile. I love this game. Leave your goat behind, yes.
Yeah.
That sounds strange.
Sounds strange, but let's leave her here then. Oh, it was a girl. Yes.
Jafar just says the same stuff. Okay. Stefan, I mean.
Yeah. Darren. Gone.
Alright.
Oh, okay, talk to him here.
Is that a well over there?
Wait, I thought Katie said she was still going to be chatting. She just lied.
Yeah, she just lied. I lost a viewer.
Ugh. Inspect the well. Yeah. Inspect it.
No matter how deep you look, you can't seem to perceive the bottom to this well. Lose yourself in its abyss.
Alright, let's lose ourselves. Yeah, what?
I love the music and the sounds in this.
You've acquired a doubled consciousness.
Keep going.
Go back, yes. So, that's through the desert, yes. So does that mean that, what's his face is now inside my brain? What was his name?
Stefan.
Guys, okay. Sergey.
Oh, Sergey.
Yeah.
Oh, I never thought of that.
Alright, let's keep going.
We can't advance any further, but we can just talk to Stefan. Jafar, stay put.
Oh!
Do you see what I'm seeing? Look, over there.
Two people. Who is it? Who is it? Who is it? There are other people in here. In here?
Not just any people.
Ooh.
Hostile. Otherworldly figures. These must be the two thieves.
Which means that the cave must be.
This reminds me of like a Sega Genesis song. The boss theme.
Over there. Behind them, where they're coming. Oh.
Your neck
was snapped in the blink of an eye.
Did your skeptic ass see your death coming? I don't need you anymore, and sadly for you, I don't feel like sharing whatever is in that cave. You can fuck off with your doubtful questions, now that the cave is within arm's reach.
Oh, I should have brought the goat. It's because I was looking at the goat that was the problem, not because I brought it. Oh, wait, your doubled consciousness shifts your senses towards the person closest to you, Stefan Burnett. Interesting.
You're Stefan now. You're Jafar and Stefan's body.
Yes. Yes.
What are the magic words?
Yes.
Oh, I like this a lot.
Open sesame.
I should have brought the goat. Katie said that's what I said too, man.
Ooh.
I'll be this guy. I'll be Mustafa. Assalamu alaikum, Stefan.
You! You're the voice I've been hearing!
And your mentor from now on, if you so wish.
Who are you?
I could go on and on about who I am, but I choose not to, lest I cloud your judgment in the choice I'm about to give you. Stefan, I need you to follow your intuition. You take the white pill, our paths separate, and the gold in this cave is all yours. You take the black pill, I make you the first of the Noid Men, and we fulfill Satan's legacy together.
Oh.
So which will it be? Look, if you go over here, he frowns, but if you go over here, he slowly starts smiling.
Oh, this is a tough one, because last time I was given a choice like this, it seems like the Noid Man was still a bad option. But I am playing Stefan, who's evil. So maybe I should become a Noid Man.
So the black belt?
Yeah, let's do it. I'll become a Noid Man.
You can get black belt by Mustafa in a little cave. You decide to swallow the black pill. Ooh. So I guess these people in the desert are annoyed, man.
What? I wonder if it's actually from October 2012 in that particular place.
Yes, I wonder if it was actually 15 degrees Celsius.
Is that Elon Musk?
Everybody keeps saying if that's Elon Musk. It did look like him. On the right?
Yeah, and then Roger Ebert. Oh, no, not Roger Ebert. George. The Star Wars guy. I can't remember.
George.
Lucas.
Yeah.
George Lucas, yeah. 1,000 years later, you become in the foreground a frontman of Sacramento-based experimental hip-hop band Death Grips. In the background, however, you and your two accomplices, Zach Hill and Andy Morin, indulge in the clandestine spreading of evil in the land of mankind. Is one of them the one with the horns from part one?
I don't know. Ooh. Oh, I thought I froze for a second.
You did. You lived.
Oh, my computer's pretty hot. You lived.
Huh. Yeah,
my computer's pretty hot.
Sexy. Yeah.
Alright, I guess I might stop the stream here just because, Elon Musk.
You beat the game.
Yeah. I wish there was more.
So was it Elon Musk and George Lucas?
I think so.
Well, I uninstalled Gnosis. I don't think that game's ever getting played again by me. So it's now in my shit list category, which is my category of Steam games that I never plan to play again. And it includes things such as, do you remember EYE, Divine Cybermancy?
Yes.
Bad Rats.
Oh, you have Bad
My
Rats?
Bones. I'm really disappointed in My Bones because I tried to play that on Halloween, but the game wouldn't actually work.
Oh, My Bones is a great game. You never played My Bones?
I know, I never got to play it.
Oh, you should.
Really upset about that. Psychonauts is in there. Because fuck that game.
Psychonauts. Oh yeah.
Yeah, remember? Yeah, it was boring. I don't understand why people love that game. I guess I kind of do. I just hated it. Team Fortress Classic, because I know I'm never gonna play it, and I just have it in my library for some reason. Gumboy Crazy Features and Gumboy Crazy Adventures.
What's Gumboy?
I don't know, but I have it. Dark Fall Lost Souls is the third game in a crappy point and click series, and I eventually gave up because I was annoyed by how slow moving everything was, and it wasn't very good. None of them were, but this was the worst one, so it's now on my shit list. And I have a bunch of games that I've beaten.
Gumboy? What the fuck is Gumboy?
I don't know.
Gumboy Crazy Adventures. And Gumboy Tournament.
Wow. So I apparently beat a game called You Have to Win the Game. I don't remember ever playing this.
What the fuck is Gumboy? Ew.
But I have apparently played this and beaten it and put it into my beaten category. I have no recollection of ever playing this game. I'm looking at pictures of it. It does not look familiar.
Is there a way to check your computer's temperature without going to the boot menu?
I use a program called HW... what do I call it? HW Info 64.
HW